Hello, thanks for stopping by. Marine here for Learn Fun, back for another Inspiration Week. Today I'm sharing with you a Magic Picture Changer card showcasing the beautiful Swan Soirée stamp set. This new set is really gorgeous and those swans definitely called for a Swan Lake themed card. I'm going to start with the oxiding background. So I cut a 5.5 by 4.25 inches stitch rectangle out of Bristol cardstock. And I'm going to use peacock feathers and blueprint sketch oxidings to create a beautiful and magical night sky. I will also add cheap sapphire oxiding at the end to darken the sky. So I first started by covering the whole panel using peacock feathers. Next, I added blueprint sketch on the edges and towards the center to create a nice halo. And like I said before, I finally added chipped sapphire on the edges to get a darker sky. You know that I never leave a background without adding details. So first, I'm splattering water on the paper using a thin brush to create a bunch of fireflies. I dry the panel using a paper towel, and next I'm adding drops of cheap sapphire oxide ink, mostly on the edges to keep the halo nice and bright. And finally, I'm using liquid stardust to create shiny stars. I've been using these products a lot lately because it's just perfect to add sparkles and magic to a card. Now I'm going to create the Magic Picture Changer element. I started by cutting two pieces of Bristol cardstock, a long panel for the pocket die and a small panel for the moving die. I mark the windows using my pencil, and next I'm stamping the images using jet black ink. And I use my Misty tool in order to stamp the swans twice and this way get a nice and crisp impression. The Magic Picture Changer pocket will go in the middle of my background panel, so I will use peacock feathers oxiding to color those two panels. But first, I mask the images. I wanted to have a white border around the swans, so they could stand out on the blue background, so I used the coordinating dies to cut masking paper. I created the same texture as the background panel, and I removed the masking paper. And because I used the coordinating dies to cut the masks, now we can see a white border around the swans. Next, I'm coloring the white swan using a very light gray marker, and I will use dark gray markers to color the black swan. When the two swans were colored, I taped the dies on the panels and sent them to my die-cutting machine. So my panels are cut, now I can add double-sided tape to the pocket tabs, front and back. I folded the pocket in half, as well as the tabs. And next I removed the backing paper on the inside and attached the tabs. I used my bone folder to press down on the tabs and also on the flaps to flatten them. This will help the mechanism to work nicely. And like always, I applied a lot of powder on the flaps and along the tabs. This will also help the mechanism to work easily. Next, I folded the pocket in half and put the moving piece through the slit. And now I'm putting each flap into a slit like so. Next, I pull on the tab to interlock the pocket and moving pieces. I apply more powder on the flaps. I remove the backing paper. And finally, I can close the pocket. Now I'm going to use the frame die from the add-on to cut a frame out of the background panel. And the pull tab will go at the top, so I make sure to put the notch side at the top. I applied the double-sided tape on the four edges of the frame and attached it on the pocket, making sure once again to put the notch side at the top. To pull the tab, I cut the handle out of blue J cardstock and I stuck it at the very top of the tab. Next, I trimmed off the remaining pieces of sky to get two large strips that I'm going to attach to a blue J card base along with the Magic Picture Changer pocket. Now the swans need water to swim, so I cut a stitch rectangle out of mermaid cardstock, and from this rectangle I'm going to cut a stitch simple wavy border. So I put both panels next to each other, I eyeballed the height of the wavy border, and sent the mermaid panel to my die cutting machine. And there we go. But to match with the rest of the background, I'm going to apply the teeny tiny bit of peacock feathers distress ink on the waves. And I will also create drops of the same ink on the border. Next, I applied double-sided tape below the swan towards the bottom of the panel, and I stuck the wavy border. I cut a rectangle out of peacock cardstock, and from this rectangle I cut a grassy border where I white heat embossed my sentiment, "Life is magical with you." The words "Life is" and "with you" are from the Swan Soirée stem set, and the word "magical" is from the Fairy Friends stem set. I added a little bit of blueprint sketch distress ink on the grass and then attached it at the bottom of my panel using foam squares. The images I stamped are from three different stem sets: Swan Soirée, Lucky Star, and Totally Awesome. And you will find all the supplies I used in the description box below the video. When the coloring was done, I cut the images using the coordinating dies, and now I'm going to stick everything using a combination of liquid glue, foam squares and glue dots. Finally, and to emphasize the magic, I added clear shimmer to the stars. And the card is done, super sweet and soft and poetic. I hope you like it, and I will see you very, very soon for another Inspiration Week card. Bye!